What's up, guys? It's Rich. Today I'm going to show you my home theater setup in my house. So basically what projector I'm using, which kind of projection screen I'm using, and basically how my devices are connected when I'm watching TV, playing a video game on the Xbox 360 or Xbox One, my Blu-ray player, Apple TV, and the desktop computer that's connected to my system here. So let's take a look. All right, so starting off with the projection screen, it's this black one right up here on the wall, the ceiling. This is an Elite Screens motorized projection screen. So this one is about, I think it's 110 inches diagonal. So it's actually it's a 16:9 ratio screen. So here I have, I don't really use this because I have a smart remote that automatically pulls down the screen. So if I just click the down button, it'll just lower, right? It'll go fully down, and then I can always stop if I want to stop it at a certain point, and then I can just bring it up with the up arrow. Okay, so moving on to the projector. Right here I have an Epson 2150. This is a 1080p high definition projector. It's fabulous compared to the other projectors I've had in the past. This one really shows, especially TV images, really clearly on the screen. Yeah, these are the connections. I have two HDMIs right now, an audio output, and then the power. But I will make a separate video specifically on the projector. Little bit later. All right, so this is where I mostly have all of my devices that's connected to the projector downstairs. So starting with this, I have a Blu-ray player. Then I have my Xbox One. Then I have my cable box for TV right here. And then this is my 5. This is a 5.1 surround sound receiver, but I just have two speakers up in the front, which are really good for the TV. So this is a Onkyo TX-NR535, which has basically most it has six inputs for HDMI right in the back over here that I just connect all my devices to the receiver, so everything just switches. The inputs are switched here. So I just have to use one HDMI port up, like right down here on the wall plate. So here I have an HDMI 2 that goes into the projector over there. And then I have an extra one up here I can use too. I got a computer input, some AVs, an audio input. That's an output, I think. I have an internet port that goes to my desktop computer right over here. And then I have the cable signal for the cable box. And then these are the speaker ports for the speaker downstairs. This is the Harmony remote that I use for my projector over here. This is really actually really useful because I don't have to have seven remotes for seven different devices. I can just use this one remote for all my devices, and it quickly powers everything on. It does the volume, all the channel inputs, and everything. Okay, so pretty much to turn the entire system on, I'm just gonna swipe open the screen, and I can click. I have certain activities here, so I have the PC, which is the desktop computer upstairs. Watch TV, which turns on the cable box. I have, let's see, Xbox One. I can watch a movie with the Blu-ray player. I can watch Netflix on my Apple TV. I can also watch Netflix. I think that's on the Blu-ray player, and then I can do screen mirroring with my laptop up on the screen. Okay, so let's do watch TV. So I'm gonna click watch TV, and all my devices are gonna turn on. So first the projector will turn on, then the screen will come down, and everything will change inputs accordingly. So let's do that now. Let's click watch TV. So as you can see, the screen, the projector turned on, and the screen is coming down too.
That we haven't had and this kind of a stretch of cold weather in a while. So the rain showers, maybe briefly heavy, will move out of here by 3-4 o'clock. They're off the east end. That's it.
So we now can see an image forming on the screen.
Good tomorrow afternoon, just a scattering of clouds, but those gusty winds will be continuing around the area, and not just for tomorrow. They'll be with us right through Thursday, the way it looks right now. It may start to ease off a little bit.
Raise the volume.
But still, it's going to be a cold stretch of weather coming up. And as you see, a 7-day, a chance of some snow Sunday.
There's my shadow.
Anticipated tomorrow around the northeast at 3 p.m. Watch the change as we go into Thursday at 3 p.m. And you're going to see how the cold air just starts to move in our direction. Okay, for tonight then, we'll have temperatures dropping down about 39.
So let me kill the lights, actually.
Showers will be moving out. Tomorrow will be partly mostly sunny day.
So that's what the screen looks like, pretty much. It's pretty big.
5 miles per hour, high is about 40.
So we can also, let's change the channel here.
The temperatures and what pops out right away, I guess, is we put a few snowflakes in there for Sunday still.
Let's see. Let's do CNN tonight. Let's see what's on.
Fog and Rockville Center.
And I can...
Charlie,
I can lower the volume to on the remote, and the volume will lower down. Okay, so once we're on the TV, we don't have to shut everything off. Once I click this off button up on the remote over here, pretty much everything will turn off and the screen will go back up. So if I want to change an activity, so let's play the Xbox One X. Basically the Xbox One will turn on. And then the receiver will change inputs, change inputs to whatever the input is on the Xbox One. This projector will stay on the same input because it's only one HDMI is going to be working. And the screen will also stay down too. So let's go to the remote and we're going to click the Xbox One X. So now the Xbox just turned on and... we should start seeing an image of the Xbox. So there you go. Now the Xbox is on. Okay, so now let's move down to the Apple TV. I'll skip some few. Okay. Well, okay, let's do a Blu-ray player and see what happens. All right, here we go. We got the Blu-ray player. Let me turn the lights on a little bit. Okay. So, and here I can also control the Blu-ray player because this remote can control that too. So let's move down to the Apple TV. Click that, and now it's changing and turning on the Apple TV. Okay, here we go. So here I can also, you know, click a movie, watch Netflix, whatever I want to do. I can AirPlay my iPad or my iPhone up on the screen. So that's cool too. So, okay. And then we can also do screen mirroring and Netflix with this setup. So yeah, this is basically it. So I have my Epson projector. It's connected to my devices over there with the receiver that is connected to two speakers in the front. So I'll actually, let's put TV on just so you can hear the sound on the screen here. Let's see what's on TV. Let's go to... let's see.
The Carfix. Up to $3,000 the day you file at H&R Block. Block has your back.
Red Rover, Red Rover. Send Reese's Pieces over. Introducing new Hershey's Milk Chocolate and Reese's Pieces. Now in one bar.
This is Ragu Simply. Simply made with 100% olive oil. Simply no sugar added. Simply dinner. Simply delicious. Ragu Simply.
Okay, so for turning off the system, I just have to click one button. That's the off button on this remote. That will turn off the projector, all of the devices, and raise the projection screen to its highest point. So let me turn on the lights here. And then let's just raise this thing up. So we're gonna click off. I'll stand back here. I'll click off. Projector turned off. Devices are off, and now the screen's going up. Alright, so that's the end of this video. Please like this video, subscribe, share, and if you guys want to see more videos of my stuff, please contact me, make a comment on the bottom. I'll try to do my best to make a video. Thanks a lot, guys. See ya.